So in this video, I wanted to go over the 10 paintings that had the greatest impact and influence on my creativity. Hello. Hello. Hieronymus Bosch is another artist that appears to be far ahead of his time. His most famous piece was painted 5 centuries ago, and yet could still be released today and look current. The Garden of Earthly Delights. I witnessed this in the Prado in Madrid and was captivated. A triptych that has little information recorded about it, but a massive amount of scholarly interpretations, seemingly represents Eden, the Garden of Earthly Delights, and Hell, as it's read from left to right across its 3 pieces. It appears to illustrate the consequences of humanity failing to follow God's will. There are numerous interpretations of this work, but the use of technique, colour, and creativity marks it as a timeless masterpiece. It could easily sit alongside modern artists' work from the likes of Jake and Dinos Chapman and appear as contemporary in a gallery. There is so much to delve into within this painting, I would advise everyone to go and see it. It spawned in me a huge interest in the crossover between art and religious history, to the point of following the progression of Lucifer from fallen angel to Satan in Dante's Inferno, particularly through the murals in the churches of Italy, France, and Spain. Bosch was a huge influence for the surrealists of the early 20th century, including Dali, Miro, Magritte, and Ernest. Moving forward about 2 centuries to another one of my great influences, the magnificent British artist Hogarth. This time I can't pick a singular painting or even a lone sequence. The Rake's Progress forms part of the collection of Sir John Soane's Museum in London, and Marriage à la Mode is in the National Gallery. To me, these 2 series of paintings are like an early pre-runner to film. A story told over a sequence of images positioning Hogarth halfway between painter and film director. As a filmmaker, you can appreciate the skill of telling such an interesting and descriptive story across just 6 or 8 frames. Both sequences are intended as a satirical and moral skewering of 18th century life. The latter story follows a young man inheriting money and falling into the stereotype of the rake, becoming embroiled in waywardness and depravity. Accentuated by Hogarth's masterful painting techniques, it shows a snapshot of life in the era, sociological, philosophical, moral, and political. I won't spoil the end of the story, but as it concludes in Bedlam, London's infamous mental asylum, you can imagine that it doesn't end well for the titular character. You can see the real parallels between this work and my all-time hero Stanley Kubrick's masterpiece, Barry Lyndon. 2 great masters dealing with a similar subject, but in different mediums and eras. Not long after A Rake's Progress came a painting that probably takes my #1 all-time favourite spot. I studied art and design and then worked in central London and would walk past the National Gallery every few days. As often as I could afford to, I would take 5 minutes to dart inside, ignoring every masterpiece contained within its collection, just so I could adoringly gaze at this piece. Whistle Jacket by George Stubbs is one of the most famous paintings in history, and its place couldn't be more deserved. This near life-size painting of a horse from an anatomical master looks like it could have been created yesterday. It's so modern and yet completely timeless. The boldness and simplicity of the background, married with some of the most beautiful painting technique I've ever witnessed, never failed to entrance me. This truly is one of the greatest artworks humanity has ever produced. Another great British master is the incomparable Francis Bacon. His paintings often have a deeply unsettling air to them in macabre colours and tones, representing his bleak existentialist outlook. He's a modern master who uses triptychs throughout his work, some of which are sold for staggering amounts. However, my all-time favourite work of his, Study for Bullfight #1, is exactly what the title describes. The most transcendent study of human and animal anatomy intertwined in a manner only Bacon could achieve. It uses a much brighter and stronger colour palette than many of his works. It's my favourite of all Bacon's works, narrowly beating so many others that this great man painted, and thankfully survived his destructive streak. There are 2 other paintings in the series, but for me, #1 has something particularly enthralling about it. The final slot in my top 10 is the most recent painting that rendered me speechless in a gallery. I was travelling through the south of France and stopped off in Albi to visit the Toulouse-Lautrec Museum. Even though I'd been to the Musée d'Orsay in Paris, which houses some of his work, I still mostly associated Lautrec with his poster work. However, when I saw his drawings and paintings in this setting, I was absolutely awestruck. My intention was to quickly speed around the gallery, as I'd arranged to meet people in the town, until I came across a certain piece, Woman Putting on Her Stocking. It's such a free-flowing piece that just seems to leap forth from the hand of a spectacularly talented artist. He committed to this sketch just enough to give a complete feeling of the subject. Of course, I got stuck in the gallery far longer than was intended and was incredibly late for my meeting, but it was well worth it to view such a beautiful creation in real life that I may never get the chance to return to. So there are the 10 paintings that I think have influenced my creative approach more than any others, and I return to on a regular basis just to bathe in their genius. What do you think of my selection? Have you ever seen any of them in real life? Which works would you add to the list or remove, and why? Please comment below, and don't forget to subscribe to Beatnik TV.